Make a 360 circle, just like this.
Spinning slowly to capture and create a 3D selfie.
Yeah, this is so cool.
Producing motion-controlled video games with all the right moves. This is all about helping a digital generation literally write its own future with the ABCs of code.
I might be an astronaut working for Google.
The Google Knot.
Seeing all this cool stuff, it's in action, it's really cool. So maybe that's one of my job things.
So is it going to be a cat?
These are the jobs of the future. And why today Google announced a $1.5 million grant to teach Canadian children how to code.
And we do camps all across the country.
A national charity will deliver the computer programming lessons in camps and after-school programs to 100,000 school-age kids across the country in the next 3 years.
We know that kids are incredible consumers of technology at a very young age. What we want to do is actually bring them from consumers of that technology to producers of that technology.
Don't just buy a new video game, make one.
From the U.S. president to NBA stars.
I know it can be intimidating.
A code campaign is already in full force in the U.S. In parts of the U.S. and all of the U.K., code is now part of school curriculums, starting as early as kindergarten.
Yeah, you're going to go that way.
Google's top exec, Eric Schmidt, says educators in Canada should also focus on a field that already has tens of thousands of job openings in this country alone.
Knowledge workers are the ones that are getting the raises, they're getting the jobs and so forth. There are shortages worldwide in all of these fields. So the education system needs to change to produce them.
Why is he going right into there?
In Canada, outliers like Cameron Steltman are leading the way. Coding is usually only offered in some schools as an elective in high school. Steltman saw the digital light and simply integrated it into his grade 6 curriculum.
They're soaking this up. Their level of excitement for it is now, and yesterday, and last year. So let's give them what they need.
Back at Google, it's clear the future is already here, and chances are these kids will be the ones shaping it. Ioana Vermiliotis, CBC News, Toronto.